Welcome to the Sheboygan County Fair. My name is Elizabeth Lindberg. I am the 2012 Sheboygan County Fairs of the Fair. And right here, I'm in the swine building, so I'm right next to my pigs here. And I had made the sale, and I'm also gonna talk to a couple of exhibitors that also have had a successful start. All right, so what's your name?
Alex.
Alex, what's your last name?
Phipps.
How did you do yesterday?
Two woods, which is pretty good, and I made the sale today.
You did? Awesome. So we will see Alex tonight at the sale. Now, what about this kid? Who are you?
I am Caden Nicholas.
All right, and how did you do yesterday?
I got second red with my gilt, and then I won my class with my barrel. And then for showmanship, I got reserve overall.
Yeah, so also Caden is up for premier exhibitor tonight as well. So we're going to have a fun time at the auction, and we will get to see and spend time with him tonight. So we also want to go meet some other people. Is this your sister? This is Caden's sister. Go talk to her. Hi, fairgoers. How are you today?
Good.
Good. So how'd your fair experience go so far?
Excellent.
Excellent.
It's a nice day out.
It is.
Everyone leaving me.
So how are the what animals are your kids showing?
My kids have pigs here and three heifers.
Three heifers. All right. And heifers show when?
Tomorrow morning at 8 o'clock.
You betcha. So I hope some people can come out here tomorrow morning for 8 o'clock show. Hi, what's your name?
George.
Your name is George? What are you doing, George?
What are you doing, George?
Are you milking a cow?
No.
No?
It's cow.
You're milking the cow? Are you having fun at the fair?
Yeah.
I can talk to you. We'll go over the side.
Can we talk to the lady?
And what are you doing?
Yeah.
Milking the cow?
Woo. Oh.
Are you having fun at the fair?
Yep.
Yeah?
First big race of the Sheboygan County Fair, and we're going to do it too, and then I'm going to tell you what, it is going to be the most spectacular about the echo from the swine pavilion. What do you think about that? Ha ha! That's weird. That's never happened before. Let me turn this down. I don't know. That's weird. Hey, we are going to be doing it too. We got about 3.5 minutes to go before 2 o'clock. We want everybody to have a good chance to come over here to the pig race track right over next to the beef barn. And of course, we are across from the swine pavilion in the animal kingdom area of the great Sheboygan County Fair grounds. And so y'all get on over here, because we're going to do this at 2 o'clock, whether you want us to or not. Because we've got kind of like a real special guest here at the pig races. And I'm going to ask her to come up here. I'm going to invite her to walk up the steps. She's going to do a much better job of that than I did. But I'd like for you to give a big warm welcome, a big Shenandoah County welcome to old Miss Liz. She's a young Miss Liz, that is. She's the fairest of the fair, and she's going to come here and give you a welcoming speech to the Sheboygan County Fair on account of where the first deal happening today. Come on up here, Liz. I want you to be real careful of the steps. And then would you please welcome everybody to the fair. What a fantastic day. Y'all are so glad to be here in Plymouth, Wisconsin, you know. Hey, the best part of it is I woke up this morning breathing. Hey, Liz, the fairest of the fair.
Hi, everyone. Like she said, my name is Liz Lindberg. I am the 2012 Sheboygan County Fairest of the Fair. I hope you're all ready for the Hendrickson's pig racing. This is the first pig racing Sheboygan County has ever had. So I think that's something pretty special. Let's give them a round of applause.
Warm
up a little bit, and you guys all do your really
big race back. Yes, indeedy, and by golly, I'll tell you what, it is going to be great. And I would like to tell you that we are Hendricks Racing Pig Team. We did come all the way from the state of Kansas. Just so you know, it's about a 14-hour drive from the farm in Kansas. We live in a tiny little town in the middle of the wheat fields. Dickerson, Kansas, where we have Hedrick Exotic Animal Farm. And I'm going to quickly tell you, just so you know, if you don't mind driving 14 hours, you can come and visit us at our farm. We have some brochures up here if you're interested. We're also on the internet, www.hedricks.com, just like up right here, except don't put the apostrophe in. The World Wide Web doesn't like apostrophes. Yeah. So anyhow, you can find out about us. We train the racing pigs there. We also have exotic animals like camels and ostriches and that sort of deal. We do a lot of neat things with animals, including racing pigs. Welcome sign. This is Brother Elroy. He's the guy I told you about being here 50 years ago or so. Ladies and gentlemen, he's going to handle the pigs. He's the finest pig trainer known to mankind. They call him the Pig Whisperer. Give him a warm Plymouth welcome to Brother Elroy. Yes. How you doing? Are you doing good?
I'm doing great.
All righty. That's fantastic. Fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, I need to find out if there's anybody here that's actually ever seen a pig race. Say, hold up your hands. Have you seen a pig race before?
Whoa.
Well, I know according to Liz, you haven't seen them here because there haven't been. But anyhow, I'm going to tell you that there was quite a number of people that didn't raise your hand. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to explain how we do this. We race pigs like they race thoroughbred horses. And I know you've seen them either in real life or maybe on TV. You know, you've watched the Kentucky Derby. And hey, just like at the Kentucky Derby, we have official starting gates that the pigs get put in. They wear racing silks. And the colors, you know about colors, red, white, blue, and yellow. Red, white, and blue is my favorite. And we threw in yellow. And they're going to... They're going to hear the sound of the call of the post. And we got a bugle boy. He came to us from over in Kentucky. He's going to sound the call of the post. It'll sound sort of like this. And then the bell's going to ring. And when that bell rings, I'm going to grab all this here start lever, and I'm going to fling this sucker way back. Them starting gates down there are going to come flying wide open. Four pigs are going to come busting out of the starting gates, and they're going to be snout to snout, slide to slide, and they're going to go rumping and bumping down that straightaway. They're going to hit the curve there on the end, and they're going to be slipping and sliding and throwing chains and all kinds of other stuff from out. He's a little camera shy, in case you didn't notice. They're going to squeal and peel around the corner down on the ham stretch, and he's going to go get our first team ready. But while he's getting these guys ready, I would like to tell you that there's going to be four pigs in each race. I'm going to kind of make a imaginary line that divides everybody in half. And that's two, and we need four, and then so we're going to divide each half in half. And the first half of the first half of the red rooter, second half of the first half of the red rooter, first half of the second half of the blue rooters, and everybody left is yellow. So you know who to yell for, red, white, blue, or yellow. Elroy's going to put silks on them. He's going to do what we call silking them up. Now this first race is our powder puff derby. And in the red, down here, in the fourth position, we have a pig. But she's pretty talented. She's one of those multitaskers, if you know what I mean. She is Oprah Swinefree. Oprah Swinefree in the red. Woo! And the pig, you can yell anytime, the pig in the right. This pig, well, we got her with us, but she doesn't have the best of reputations. She's more what you call notorious rather than popular. This is Lindsay Loham. Lindsay Loham in the right. And the pig in... Blue, the pig in blue. You know, they told me, now Lois, everybody knows Lois. I know everybody knows Lois. Lois said, you know, this is an election year, so we don't want you to get too crazy about that, because you know how these people in Sheboygan County are. Anyway, the pig in blue, yeah, she used to run for the president's thing, but she's from a neighboring state. This is Michelle Parkman. Michelle Parkman in the blue. And right next to me, right down here, probably the oldest one of the crew, she is none other than Swillery Ludham Clinton. Are you ready, pig fans?
Yeah.
That was quite the pig race. Now remember, these girls all will do anything at all they can for a photo op. There's Oprah, especially Oprah. She has to do everything twice to make it come out right. Ladies and gentlemen, what a pig race. Now we're going to have two... Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to see pig racing like you've never seen pig racing before in your life. And of course, these pigs are a little on the little of the small side, but they're going to wear our quarter pig silks. Yes, you've heard about quarter horse racing. These are quarter pigs. Ladies and gentlemen, the pig in red, Barack Obama. Barack Obama in the red. And in the blue light, the pig next to him is his sidekick. This is Joe Bacon. Joe Bacon in the light. And the pig in blue. The pig in blue, this is Mitt Hanley. Mitt Hanley in the blue. And riding shotgun for Mitt, this is Hog Ryan. Are you ready, pig fans? That was a mistake. The second. There we go. This electronic stuff doesn't agree with me very well. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the famous 2012 Pig Race.
All right, I'm here in the dairy barn with Miss Ella Bindle. So Ella, how are you today?
Good.
Good. What are you showing tomorrow?
Some calves.
You're showing some calves in the open show?
Yeah, in the open show.
And the open show starts tomorrow at 8:30. Saturday at 8:30. Also, I have here is Miss Ava. Ava, what's your last name?
Booth.
And what are you showing today?
Tomorrow.
Well, Saturday.
I'm showing a winter calf and a March calf.
A March calf. All right. How about Cammy? Do you want to come here? Or Adam? Come here, Adam. All right. So what are you showing on Saturday?
A cow.
A cow? Mm-hmm. Is that it? Yeah?
March cow.
A March cow. All right. And how about you, Campbell? What? Are you showing anything on Saturday?
A cow.
You're showing a cow too? How about you? Are you showing in the junior show?
Yep.
Okay. And when is the junior show?
Tomorrow, I believe.
It is tomorrow. And what are you showing?
A heifer.
You're showing a heifer. So good luck to all the exhibitors, and I hope people can come join us tomorrow for the junior show and on Saturday for the open show.
The glory of the Lord, amen. Christ, the prophet is saying, the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali, by the way of the sea beyond Jordan, Galilee and the Gentiles, Tiles, the people of which sat in darkness, saw great light. And to them which sat in the region in shadow of death, light is sprung up.
This morning we are pleased to have Pastor Dwayne Humke with us. Dwayne Humke is a Sheboygan County native who has graduated from Sheboygan Falls High School. He received his Master of Divinity degree from Western Theological Seminary in Holland, Michigan, and has served Reformed Church of America, Iowa, congregations in South Dakota, Iowa, and Illinois. Now retired, Reverend Humke is a hospice chaplain and a funeral home chaplain. He and his wife, Rita, live in Sheboygan Falls. Welcome, Pastor Humke, to the Victoria Church Service.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I sometimes, on Saturday nights, take a good look up into the grandstand of the Saturday night races, and maybe I see some of you up there. Maybe you see me, because I usually am the pastor leading the invocation prior to the singing of the national anthem on Saturday nights, if you're a Saturday night race car fan. But it is a joy. I've never been to the county fair on a Sunday morning, and especially for the worship service. So I consider it a real honor to be here this morning and be asked to share some words with you. I know that I've had a lot of advice making sure that this morning our service would not run long. I had one individual, I was here Thursday night for the tractor pull, and I had a person that I knew come, and we were talking about the service this morning, and he says to me, you know, if you can't say it in 10 minutes as a pastor, you might as well just forget it, because you're going to lose the people after 10 minutes. Now, I wanted to make sure I looked at the source of the person who was speaking to me. I was wondering if that's the attention span of that particular person. So, I've had another person indicate to me, being a pastor, that I should remember the five B's. And I said, five B's. Yeah. He said, you've never heard about the five B's? I said, no, I've never heard about the five B's. So he held up his hand and he said, be brief, brother, be brief. So I've been getting a lot of advice concerning the length of the worship service, but no one really gave me an indication as to what the content of our worship should be this morning. So I chose a passage of scripture that probably is somewhat familiar to you and to me. It comes out of Jesus' words as he was sitting on a hillside looking out at a crowd. And I'm just thanking God this morning for the crowd that's here on the Sunday morning at the county fair. A number of people that I look out and I know them, I know who you are. Others are maybe exhibitors or other people who've come to enjoy the fair. I was visiting with a family, a couple up here in front. I said to them, how nice. They came and they sat up front, because I said, in most church services, the first couple of pews are rather sparsely filled. And I'm seeing this morning. And they said they came from Port Washington area, and they came to the fair, and this is their first time to the Sheboygan County Fair. So we've got some people who probably have come for many years to the fair, maybe even to this worship service, and a couple down here their first time. So we want it to be an enjoyable worship experience also this morning. And I think for 40 years, this has been a wonderful thing. I didn't realize that it was that long that the county fair has offered Sunday morning worship service. And I'm thankful for some of the churches in the area that maybe aren't having worship this morning and encourage some of their people to come here and to be a part of worship. But as I said, Jesus was looking over a crowd and he was doing some teaching. And he got to the place where he shared a number of words that we would know as the Beatitudes. The fifth chapter of the Gospel of Matthew. He shares the words about blessed are so-and-so, so-and-so, blessed are so-and-so. attitudes of being. And then as he continued to share what we call his Sermon on the Mount, he came to some words that he shared about salt and light. Now I'm going to hold off in case I do get an invitation to come back and share at another service, depending on whether I go past 10 minutes or not. I'll speak maybe on salt, but this morning I want us to focus for just a little while upon those words that he said about light.
Oh. Hi, we're here at the Sheboygan County Fair enjoying the beautiful weather, and we're standing actually in the Dairy Education Zone. So be sure to stop by and check it out. There's lots of great materials and goodies. We are featuring Beechwood cheese here today behind me, and we're handing out samples as we celebrate the dairy industry, which is 26.5 billion dollars strong, almost half of our $59 billion agriculture industry here in Wisconsin. So I'm looking forward to seeing the many exhibitors participating in the Holstein Futurity here shortly and just enjoying a really great day to highlight Wisconsin agriculture.
Shaw County to the farm east of Waldo. The bell in Mission Farm, or Mission Bell Farm, refers to a bell that came from Kentucky and has been in Paul Lehman's family for over 150 years. They purchased the farm from Walter Dane. Registered Holsteins were purchased a few at a time, and now the herd is 100% registered. The farm is currently operated by Tom and Beth and Jerry and Marty Jen's families. Tom and Beth have two children, Joe and Ann, and Jerry and Marty have five children, Aaron, Nick, Kelly, Jimmy, and Sean. The farm consists of 100 milk cows, 125 young stock, and 500 acres. The farm has bred over 65 excellent cows, 19 gold medal dams, 43 cows over 200,000 pounds of milk lifetime, and received the Progressive Breeders Award 14 times. Shakira had a two-year-old record of 19,798 milk, 3.65% fat, 722 pounds fat, and 2.94% protein, with 581 pounds protein in 298 days. Fidget had a two-year-old record of 24,342 milk, 3.24% fat, 803 fat, 2.80% protein, and 708 pounds protein.
Number three, Phoenix Acres Linden Spirit. Jim and Kim have three children, Sarah, age 11, and Austin, 9-year-olds, and Caitlin, who is 6. They took over the Deerview Acres operation from Jim's parents, Bernie and Arliss Henschel. Deerview Acres lies between Road America and the Broughton Sheboygan Marsh Park. The farm consists of 150 cows with a rolling herd average of 23,000 pounds of milk, 4.1% fat. Raven, E.T., who was sired by Bolivier. Raven is excellent 92E with an excellent acres, Reagan. They are looking forward to the future generations of offspring from this family. Please welcome Deerview Acres and their two entries into the ring.
Entry number five, Devon Acres Sydney Haven, presented by Kendra. 1972, that's 140 years. Kevin and Deb are the of 29,118 pounds of milk, 4.02%.
Hi, I'm Alyssa Vaness. I'm at the Sheboygan County Fair. I ride hunt and western and do showmanship with my horse Trigger. We just got done riding drill team and our theme is Batman this year, so turned out really nice. You guys should all come next year and see. Thanks.
All right, my name is Abigail Sonnentag and my horse's name is Royal Crest Snowstone. I've had her for 5 years. We're from Sheboygan County and we live in Plymouth. I've been working with her for 5 years, and this is her fourth year on English drill team.
Hi, my name is Chelsea Winter. I'm in the English drill team. This is my horse, Cassie. She is a quarter horse mare that's 21 years old.
How long have you been training?
We've been training a while. All summer, me and my team has been training, and it's been really exciting and stuff.
Did you win any award?
This year at the fair, I got a first and 3 seconds, so then I'm eligible to go to state.
How about your friend? What's her name?
My name is Haley
Knack.
I am 13 years old, and I am on a team with Chelsea.